Once upon a time. All good fairy tales start with once upon a time. In a land far, far away, there was a young man who roamed the countryside. This young man had a kind and generous heart. Good fortune being what it will, and fairy tales being what they will, blessings in abundance followed this man. One day he came upon a magnificent kingdom. Well, every fairy tale with a kingdom has a king, of course, and every king has a beautiful princess. And this one's no different. The young man with the kind and generous heart discovered that he and the beautiful princess were destined to be together. Magically, they were born in the same castle maternity ward. The princess, just 3 weeks before him.
He married an older woman.
As magic and destiny would have it, the young man and princess fell in love and married. The king was pleased. The king's son, the castle prince, was pleased. The children of the kingdom were most pleased because the king and the castle prince and the young man and the princess with the kind and generous hearts created a beautiful toy land. It was a kindly kingdom of toys, or K&K for short. Soon there were K&K stores everywhere. Once again, magic and destiny would have their way with the kind and generous-hearted young man and his princess. Alongside the many toy stores sprung up a variety store, kind of a toy store for people of all ages. A dollar store. Soon they collected many, many dollars at their dollar store. So many dollars that they wanted to give them away to people who needed them more than they did. So they gave many of their dollar store dollars away to the people of the kingdom. The young man believed and often said, "You can't take it with you."
When's the last time you saw a hearse pulling a U-Haul?
There are leaders, and then there are leaders with heart. They seek to encourage, to educate, to inspire. Joan and Macon Brock are two such leaders. And tonight, we honor them and we celebrate their lifelong dedication to love, beauty, and commitment.
Our parents grew up here. They came from the Carolinas and up here in the 30s. And so, of course, we love the place because the beaches.
You know, when you're homegrown, which is what I call ourselves, you know a lot of people, you know? I mean, as we all know, nothing happens in a silo. It's all about teamwork. And the more like-minded people that are together, the more things can get done.
Joan and Macon are the driving force behind initiatives that enhance our community, encouraging others to step up and get involved. The result is a legacy that will last generations.
It's like-minded people, you know, and they want to make something happen. And so they lock arms and the project grows and people get all on board and just, you know, It's the way philanthropy works,
that's
and it should work, collaborations.
So that happened the same way with the Chrysler. We had so many other people join the campaign that we literally transformed the Chrysler. When you look at it sort of in hindsight, but recently, to try to work in different fields of philanthropy, one, of course, would be arts for the Chrysler Museum. The other would be the medical area where the EVMS Brock Institute now resides. And we're very much interested in the environment. And so Joan and I made the lead gift to what's now the Brock Environmental Center, which is doing magnificently well.
Joan and Macon are deeply committed to improving the lives of others, not just here in Hampton Roads, but as far away as Sierra Leone.
When you do philanthropic work, your path takes you down an avenue you didn't realize that you really had an interest in, and one thing leads to another.
Joan and Macon's steadfast dedication to the education of young people in Hampton Roads drove them to provide leadership within the Access College Foundation to provide scholarships, resources, and support to young people who otherwise wouldn't have had access to higher education opportunities.
I got excited about that because I know what people can do together. We've had partnerships with our philanthropy all along, and one of the first ones was when I was the board chair of the Access College Foundation.
This foundation is nurturing the children, the kids, on how to get into college. That was a partnership that we like doing, and then when you do it, you see the results.
In Joan and Macon Brock, we see what is possible when we care enough to get involved. to look for opportunities to serve, to lift others up, to inspire.
But it's the practice of participation and giving what you can, which is all you ever want. And I think my first gift, I'm told, I don't remember it, was to Randolph-Macon, where I graduated in 64. And I must have given $5, and the next year $10, so that was a big increase percentage-wise.
A practice of participating and giving. That practice has generated so much for Hampton Roads, from two people who know a good bit about love, beauty,